喂，大家好啊，又係昌王啊！今次咧見到 EMM 的老闆啦，係啊嚟到香港，咁所以咧，因為 EMM 咧最近就出咗兩部最新嘅 deck 嘅，嗱咁所以咧今次咧就梗係要問一下阿老闆，究竟佢介紹一下呢部 deck 啦。
So the DA2 and MA3, the DA2i and the MA3i converters is our new generation of flagship DACs. And they have a bunch of technologies inside of them that make them very special from the competition. We do things not because they're easy, but in fact because they're hard to do. And because of that, we're able to forge our own path and we're able to do things the way that we want them done from start to finish of the signal path. So inside of a DAC, inside of the signal path, you're going to have your input stage. So all of your inputs have to be galvanically isolated and you have to arrange for the input scheme, the adaptive locking mechanism to the input. So we do that ourselves inside of our products. Because of this, we're actually able to reduce jitter, incoming jitter from source-borne materials. The other thing that we have to do is we have to process, we have to upsample, we have to use DSP in our modulator inside of the DAC. So that upconverts everything to 16 times DSD, DSD 1024. And when we do that ourselves, we're able to perfectly tune it to the point where once it gets to the clock, we know exactly what we're dealing with. We also design our own asynchronous clocking mechanism based on a frequency locked loop instead of a traditional phase locked loop. And this is very important for maintaining the timing integrity of the DAC and of the signal itself. From there, we go from our own asynchronous clock into our proprietary single bit converters, dual mono configuration, left and right. That's our 16 times DSD DACs inside of our product that Ed Meitner has been known for the better part of three decades now. From there, we go into our own design analog output stage. And this is one of the things that in the new products, the MA3i and the DA2i, that's very, very special, is that we designed an analog output stage that's known as a folded cascode design. A folded cascode design is usually used in the telecommunications and data transfer industries for its speed, accuracy, and wide bandwidth. So what we've done is we've applied that scheme, that philosophy into the audio space. And because of that, we can boast that we get over 100 kilohertz of open loop bandwidth, completely flat to 100 kilohertz. We get very, very clean and dynamic response. It maintains the visceral impact, it maintains the clarity, the timing, and the precision that people love while not sacrificing on musicality. And I think that's what I would really classify our DACs, our D2A converters as, is very musical, very accurate, very fast and responsive, but maintaining that musical aspect to it.
Okay.
So the MA3i and the DA2i, they do not support DSD 1024 files.
Yes.
This is a misconception. What we're doing is we upsample all incoming data streams to DSD 1024. And then at the clock, that's the speed that we're running at before we go into our dual mono DACs. We actually support through the network and through the USB inputs on our DACs, we support up to 2x DSD. Because we believe that 2x DSD is the sweet spot in that format. There is some source material out there in DSD 256, but I think it's very, very limited. And we will get there eventually so that we can support that limited number of files that are out there that people want to play. But in our opinion and in Ed's opinion, coming from the person who made DSD a reality, we don't believe that it's very important to be able to support the DSD 256 and DSD 512 and on and on and on. Because none of these pieces of music were actually even recorded in that format. When we're talking about DSD, we're talking about the Sonoma workstation, which is the DSD console that they use to record in DSD. When we want to listen to DSD, I think that we should be listening to pieces of music that started off as DSD and that remain as DSD. And that's our position on the DSD format wars. But we do believe, again, talking about the clock, talking about the speed at the clock, if we can get that 16 times DSD speed at the clock of our upsampler before we go into our dual mono DACs, that's a win, absolutely. But when we're talking about the format wars and people that are only looking for the specs on, oh, this can support, we saw this with MQA, but that's different than the speed that we operate at. The speed that we operate at is completely different than the file format that we're talking about. And we saw the same thing with MQA. When MQA was in its up and up, and maybe they might come out with their streaming service, which I believe we're going to talk about streaming services next. When they come out with their streaming service, people are going to be, manufacturers like us, like Meitner and EMM Labs, we're going to be somewhat forced to adopt a new streaming service because, and this new file format like MQA was, even if the vast majority of the market doesn't necessarily want to use it. But we will support our customers, we'll support their needs, and like I said, eventually we'll get there that we can support the 4x DSD as well. But at the moment, we don't have any plans to do that right away. We have much other more important things to do in advancing the state of the art of our amplification, of our D-Day converters, of our preamps. We now have a new CD transport. Coming up soon, we're going to have CD players in the market. You know, we have a lot to do and so little time that we want to make sure that we put our efforts where it will be appreciated the most. So the branding decision was actually made better part of 20 years ago, actually.
Yeah.
And the reason for it was we wanted to have an entry-level brand, an entry-level selection of products that would appeal to maybe a younger generation. Mm. Mainly taking products that we had, like the TSDX and the DAC2X was an SACD player and a DAC back in the previous years of the company. From that, we decided that we wanted to make an XDS1, which was an all-inclusive SACD player with a DAC inside of it. Mm. Then we said, okay, well, maybe younger generation, maybe they don't care about DSD or SACD. Mm. So we decided to make the Meitner MA2, okay? And then we had the MA1, which was a slimmed-down version of our flagship DAC back in the day. The branding question is a funny one because the idea was that we wanted to have an entry-level brand and we wanted to have a different name for it so that people could still associate the flagship, the cost no object, the top of the line with EMM Labs. But then we have a more affordable, user-friendly brand name like Meitner with the MA3. When the MA3 came out, it's been by far our most well-received product in the history of the company. I think the reason for it is because it was a slimmed-down package with a no-frills approach to being a streaming DAC with a volume control that you could hook up directly to your powered speakers or a small amplifier. And that's exactly what it went out to do. It's become much more than that now, which is amazing to see. And we want to continue doing products in the Meitner brand because we think that it offers a value proposition to our customers. And they see what we can do in the EMM Labs side of things, and they say, I want a piece of that. So I'm going to buy the Meitner. Absolutely, yeah. So recently we just announced that we're now Qobo's Connect, which is very, very great for our customers. It's been received very, very positively. Tidal Connect as well came with the MA3i and the DA2i. As we see these new streaming services pop up, and I'm not very familiar with the ones that are available in Asia, but I do know that there's quite a few that are available in Asia that we don't necessarily have in the USA. But we are working with our partner who helps us to integrate the streaming features, and we will be introducing new streaming features into the future, absolutely.
Oh, okay.
And because we can do over-the-air updates with the MA3i and the DA2i, in the example of Qobo's Connect, it was a simple firmware update, and then all of a sudden customers had the ability to use Qobo's Connect, which was fantastic for everyone. Their DAC completely took on a new life, their MA3i took on new life just overnight, releasing a new firmware. So that's very nice to do, and we want to continue to do that. It's definitely a possibility. I think what I would say is that it doesn't really fit with the Meitner branding to develop a standalone CD transport, because the Meitner brand is all about taking what we've done in the EMM Labs brand and then condensing it into a very simple to use package. So what I would ask your viewers to really look forward to is eventually a new Meitner player, which is going to be a streaming DAC with a CD player inside of it, with all of your digital inputs, and who knows, maybe some analog inputs as well. Because that's what we want to do in the Meitner brand. We want to condense the technologies and trickle them down into a way that more people can use more features with a simpler product. So that's what I would say on the CD transport. Now, the new CD transport, the TXI EMM Labs, has been received really, really well because of its ability to be used with the DA2i and DV2i converters. Using the DA2i and DV2i, you're able to control the TXI and remove one hassle out of your life. It's basically just, I would call it, for lack of a better word, a dumb box, because it doesn't work without the DA2i, and we've packaged it together with the DACs now to make a really amazing package that people so far really love to use, and they love the sound of it, and I'm excited for you guys to hear it one day.
Oh, okay. 好啦，咁今次咧好開心，大家都攞到有關 EMM 最新嘅資訊啦，係啦，咁啊 OK，thank you for coming。
謝謝，再見。
好啦，拜拜。